I hope you guys had a wonderful Christmas season and you were Zooming with your family and friends. I was talking with a lot of people on the phone and on FaceTime, and it was wonderful to kind of say hello to everybody and connect. Well, we're finally past the holidays, but not really, because the day after the holidays is still the holidays as far as I'm concerned. But we're going to do the numerology and the astrology for December 26, 2020. If you add all those numbers together, you get the number 15. If you add the 1 and the 5 together, you get the number 6. Now, you know that the number 6 is the number of Saint Hildegard. It is a number of meditation, introspection, stillness, spirituality, religions, contemplation, meditation, inward focus. And so today is a day that we reflect maybe on yesterday, hopefully, with great fondness and smiles. Today is a day where quiet becomes us. As we move towards the end of the year, think how much we have accomplished since the pandemic hit. We have learned so much. We have made our homes homier. Our creative expression has blossomed, and our health has improved in many ways just by taking the stress down a few notches. We have realized how much saving a few hours a day by not needing to drive to work improves energy, connection, and stress. Business, as we know it, will change forever. Life, as we know it, has changed forever. And in this midst of it all, each of us is grappling with this new reality and how to fit into this rapidly changing construct. That is why today, some contemplative time might be helpful. Do what you can to make your life smoother, more balanced between work and life. Choose connection over habit. Reclaim time so you can learn to enjoy your life rather than just rush through it. The astrology today. The sun and Chiron square exactly, and it brings in some feelings of hesitation. Perhaps it has been a tough year. And now we have a moment to think through this tremendous moment in history. And while it still is going on in horrific ways, in this moment we are shocked at where the world seems to be now. The moon is in Taurus until dinner time, at which point it goes into the curious and mentally active sign of Gemini. So part of the day is all about practical things, getting the house back in order, getting turkey off the bone, putting things away to use later, getting the paper and the garbage out of the house, all those things. But this evening is more about communicating and being connected, looking at life with renewed curiosity and clarity, and finding ways to be happy and productive. The moon is in a happy place with Saturn and Jupiter. Productivity and happiness are at the top of the list. Great time to start projects. It seems we are here to learn to control our temper and to become more impartial and objective. Blending intellect, balance, and intuition is on the line right now. My quote for today is a little long. It's more like a paragraph. I look into my past and I see so much light and fear. I honestly know that so many things seemed terrifying, new, and comfortable when I was younger. But that is what youth is about, stretching out of the comforts of home and safety. I am grateful for the consistency, stability, and love that I got to experience. And that is not to say that there were not challenges, problems, issues, and complications. All of those things arise when you are a soul having a human experience. But my soul recognized that if I allowed the fear to have control over my soul, I would not accomplish anything. Success is always on the other side of fear. And from a young age, I knew that to be true. Never let fear allow the mind to make up excuses for not trying new things. Never stop the lessons life presents. See all problems as great and transformative gifts. And my blog for today. Yesterday we had a quiet day starting out working on this blog for all of you, and I started to work on it about 6 a.m., which is what I normally do. And then when my husband woke up, we began to finish the repairs on the hot tub. Our Christmas gift to each other was a new hot tub cover, and we resealed it yesterday. So this morning we got to take the tape off and began filling it with water. Oh, yay. Perfect for hot cocoa in the tub and watching the rain that began to fall this morning and that should last all week. My other goal is to get the turkey breast in the oven. Now, I overdid it a little bit for Christmas. I wanted Cornish game hens, but when we could not find any in town, then my husband was searching for some things in Ukiah and found them. But by that point, I had already bought the turkey breast, which, you know, now I've got too much food, right? So the turkey breast will make perfect sandwich meat. And so I have it cooking now before I have to put the hens in the oven. It is smelling heavenly now at 9:30 a.m. I also have an agenda to take out my easel and I got as a present from my sister for my birthday and try some painting. Now, don't expect Leonardo da Vinci to show up. This is my first ever attempt. I plan on watching some of the YouTube videos and just getting some basics down. So it's going to be a quiet Christmas and very relaxing. I hope you all have the same and enjoy the many gifts and treasures learned from 2020. The attitude of gratitude is high this morning. We all made it through 2020. Woo, woo, woo! That is quite an accomplishment. And sending prayers and love to those that had family that did not make it through the pandemic, and also to those that have friends and family ill right now. We will get through this. There is light at the end of the tunnel, and we are all heading that way together. Have a wonderful day.